So you're going to design a circuit. You need to do the design process before you actually start assembling, because if you don't have the right resistor, you could destroy your LEDs or underpower them. So it's important to do the design step first. So here I have another representation of a battery by having my positive terminal here, my negative terminal down here. And because we are using 9-volt batteries, I'm showing that this potential here is at 9 volts, and as the power is used up, it goes down to 0 volts down here. So in this space here, I'm going to insert the right resistor. Okay, so here's my symbol for a resistor, or one of them anyway. And let's say I'm using these white LEDs. Okay, we've got, and let's say we have a brand new battery. It's about 9 to 9.6 volts. And so therefore, at the beginning, the voltage used up by this part here is going to be up to 3.2 volts, right? Therefore, all we have to do to work out the resistance of our resistor is the first step. Step one is to work out the leftover voltage to be used up by the rest of the circuit, in this case, the resistor, right? So therefore, we've got the voltage of the resistor, VR, equals the total voltage, which is 9, minus 3.2. And we get a value of 5.8 volts. Now, when you think about it, this is a silly design, because if I still have 5.8 volts left, well, why don't I just insert another LED rather than waste my voltage in a resistor which does almost nothing except convert electricity to heat? So, but anyway, I'm just showing this for demonstration purposes. And that's the resistor voltage used up right here. And to work out the resistance of this resistor, we just do the second part of the calculation, and that is work out the resistance. So I use Ohm's law again, and R for the resistor. The resistance of the resistor is going to be using this formula here, VI over I, and which is 5.8. I really need to get a new pen. Divided by 0.02 amps. So remember, 20 milliamps is the optimal current for these LEDs. Therefore, when you convert 20 milliamps into amps, you divide by 1,000, you get 0.02. So they are the same thing. 20 milliamps and 0.02 amps are the same thing. But you have to do your calculations in full amps and full voltage and so on. Otherwise, you'll get the wrong values. Now, let's work out the solution to this equation. Okay, and here's my calculator. So 5.8 divided by 5.8 divided by 0.02 equals 290 ohms. So therefore, when you go about building this circuit in series, you need a resistor with a resistance of about 290 ohms. Okay, so if you get a 300 ohm resistor, that should be good enough. If you get a little bit less than 300 ohms, that's okay too. It's approximate, and that's more than okay. Now, when you go about doing your calculations, it's always a good idea to base your total voltage on the lower end of the battery performance. Otherwise, you'll find that your LEDs won't work for too much long because the battery power will be diminished and they will lose illumination. So you're better to design on the lower end of the voltage of the battery. So rather than 9.6 volts, design for 9 volts or 8.8 volts or something like that. And that way your LEDs will last, will glow for longer. However, just keep in mind, don't have the voltage too low, otherwise you risk damaging the lifespan of your LEDs. So if the battery is 9 volts, then I think just design for everything based on 9 volts. And of course, when you go about testing your circuits, you can use the classroom power supply, the transformer packs. And I would use 10 volts actually, because for a short time, 10 volts won't really damage your circuit. But doing for long-term design, then of course you want to base it on 9 volts. But for testing and assembly, you can just try the power packs at 10 volts.